Hey, my friends, I'm starting a new RAV tutorial series where I'm going to condense some of the ideas that are in my one-on-one private sessions into videos that can be digested really quickly and easily. This particular video is going to be talking about breaking out of your habits and how to not make everything you play sound the same. I notice a lot of percussionists tend to have a style in which one note is really the root of everything they're doing, and because of this, it's hard to differentiate between songs that they're playing. And this is just because they're not thinking about it compositionally. There's nothing wrong with that, and that's a perfectly valid approach to playing. But for somebody who wants their instrument to have different songs, to have different feelings, different emotions, rather than just driving with the rhythm, we can change our root note and change some of our patterns to make it more interesting. So let's take a look at how to do that real quick. All right, so sometimes you'll see players who really focus on rhythm. And when I'm talking about that, I'm saying stuff that's like, in this case, what's driving the sound is the rhythm itself. What's driving the song or the structure is solely that. And this style of playing is great for some of the trickier scales because individual notes are going to sound better on those when tied to the root in the center. However, if we're looking to write something that has some longevity to it, I really recommend learning to alternate your root notes and to break out of your patterns. So, let's say that our pattern for this is 7, 6, 5, 4. And again, this will work on whatever scale. So this is our pattern. So playing those four notes, I know I have a 7, 6, 5, and 4. I'm aware of which side I'm using, I can say, oh, we're starting that first example, 7, 6, 5, 4, on the right side. So if I wanted to make something sound related to it, but different, I could start on that side and take the 7, and then the note below it, which is the 5, over to the 6, and the note below the 6, 6 and 4, over to the 5, and the 4 underneath it. 4 and 2. So our initial pattern can be transformed into the playing dyad pairs with the notes from our melody. Anytime you come up with a certain series of notes that you like, try to remember that note, because that's going to allow you to develop and move forward. When you're only focusing on one note as your root, you're missing out on so much potential on these instruments because they're melodic percussion. So it really is important to vary that as you're playing. Here's that same movement from a different angle. So we started with 7, 6, 5, and 4. And we said we could reverse that and do 4, 5, 6, 7. Also pay attention to the dyads, so we could do 7, 5, 6, and 4, 5, and 3. Super simple way of doing it. One of the biggest things I work on with my students is creating differentiated music. A lot of what's available online for RAV and handpan tutorials, it's taught by drummers. Again, nothing wrong with that. But most players, when they listen to music, aren't saying, oh, I really like that this is in 3-4 or 4-4. I really like the 3-3-2 pattern. That's not how the casual player and the casual listener is engaging with a song. They're thinking, oh, I like the melody for this. The melody is catchy. Where is this going to go next? And because we've spent so much time listening to music, our brains kind of know which direction a song is going to go before it happens. And this is true of everybody, whether you're a musician or you're sort of aspiring musician. Because of this, being aware of how we anchor our playing is going to make a huge difference in how the listener connects to the music and how the song kind of adapts to the situation you want to create within it. And again, changing the direction that you're going in a pattern, changing from individual notes to dyads is a great way to do it. And most of all, just pick some patterns, make a note of what numbers they are, and use that as your basis to create something new. Sometimes just reversing something is enough to break you out of the habit, but stop thinking about it like a drum. It's so much more than just a drum, it's so much more than percussion. And you have an opportunity, because it's so simplified, to create music in a way that's accessible, almost in the way that a harmonica is accessible. So take the opportunity you're given with these instruments and create melody on top of your percussion. And I think you're gonna have a lot more success in satisfying your own needs and also your listeners. So ultimately, the important takeaway is that altering one aspect of it can change the feeling of where you're going. The main thing that people need to think about is, how do I integrate these techniques together? How do I put these patterns together or rhythms together so that it sounds cohesive? The biggest problem people have when they're going to create their own music is making it feel connected. So this is one step in learning how to connect pieces of what you write together. If you're interested in private lessons or group lessons, I offer online workshops, one-on-one, and in 15 to 20 people as well. And you can contact me here or any of my links below. And the main takeaway I want you to have, don't think about it like a drum, and start to expand the way you approach it and integrate new developments to it. Talk to you soon.